Puppy. Moo knows it. The intent is also here, and Puppy gets attacked with Mel. The Horde stomp. He's gonna get himself out. The Fissure will go off. Moo, where's that last attack? He gets it. First blood goes to Templar Assassin. The Horde stomp follows up again. Dendi tossing back the Centaur. There's another kill, this time going the way of the Enchantress.
Fight over the stack. This might be the fight. Michelle, he's got Ravage back. He's cutting it off.
Like, bring it on.
For the experience, Ravage can come out. Static Storm's gonna be there as well. He did pay his life for it, but I think everybody's gonna die as a result. But Bulls, oh, what a call! What a hook with the glimpse back here. No, what did the
he died.
Go? He died.
He died. The Enchantress impetus reached him, and then Hal able to follow up with the attack into the clockwork, picking him off. Hal looking for the kill over on Kuro. Back inside the base, flies up towards the high ground. The impetus damage from Banana really working hard. Hal's inside the base, under the tier 3 tower. Reserve Ward's down as well, trying to see anyone who's moving up, and they're going for a trade-off.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Relocate in to be part of this one. They're using a DD to try to beat down this tower. At the same time, he's still sitting behind it. He sees where Sunshine is all the way to the back.
The fortification is making it a little bit more difficult
for the Radiant Sun to bring down that mid tower. While the top tower has still got fortification, waiting for this relocate. Of course, he's almost used the entire duration. They see Hal going out of here and hookshot in. They're just looking for the stragglers. Banana will be the first one. Hal, as he was teaming out, but he time lifts himself back into the engagement, looking for a boss. Ravage comes out. Jalway, Phonic in a boss, they're about to go down with a Weave of Scarabs over on him. Phonic will take a fall on Hal.
It's gonna be like a 22-minute deso at this rate.
As Horvost towards the front lines of the Plaza Field, he'll get rid of the Undead Army, but the bugs come out and they're on the back of a horse. He's already got that negative armor with the Melt negative one, glimpse straight back in. And Horvost just came out to sniff the roses, but pushes up the daisies instead. 20-4 with no Razor available. I don't know if Newbie just want to go on the back of this creep wave. Push high ground. They still have Ravage.
Why not?
Every single ultimate available.
Aegis just expired, but you have BKB on Moose, so that's his protection.
Yep.
They don't have
this
aggressive push that they did last game.
Tossing Echo, but there's a Ravage already ready. Static Storm's going to come up. Ravage's going to hit on everybody. And look at them die under that Static Storm.
They were in there for a second, and now they're not.
That was meant to be the Hallelujah jump in, but the second you hook yourself in and the Static Storm came out from Sunshine, there was no way to pop up any ability, and now the wall is up again. Dendi is trapped inside of this. Puppy with the Fissure, keeping Xiaowei to move away. The boss, he is not where he wants to be. Outside of the base, Xiaowei on low life, back himself up, but Hal is going up against the boss with Banan's pure damage to the appears, working hard, and Puppy evaporates to the Meld hit. Oh, this is just like Mercy. Mercy, please.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
All of the spells are being used. They don't have buyback because they just use it as well. I don't know. Navi and Snake's about to lose that round.
Now, maybe even just lose the game. Now, Tendi turns from Avalanche Toss, but the Meld hit strikes on the negative 8 armor on him, and it's so easy to finish the job. Whisper's gone. GG 20 minutes in. Quick series, good.